We are looking at feasibility analysis, financial feasibility analysis. So we began by looking at product service feasibility analysis, and then we look at industry target market feasibility analysis, and then we looked at management feasibility analysis, and now we are looking at the fourth item, which is the financial feasibility analysis. So let's go into the financial feasibility analysis. What is the purpose? What is the purpose of financial feasibility analysis? So this is the final component of a comprehensive feasibility analysis, of course, which we are aware of, the final stage. So it is also a preliminary financial assessment to ascertain whether you are financial worthy, prepared to actually launch your business. Okay, your assessment is sufficient enough to be able to gain the output or to make the needed output for whatever reason for which you are establishing. Okay, so if you are talking about financial feasibility analysis, then we have three core components in mind. The first one is the startup cash needed. The second one is the financial performance of similar businesses. And then the third thing we'll look at is the overall financial attractiveness of the proposed venture. So let's take it one at a time. So the total startup cash needed. The first issue refers to the total cash needed to prepare the business to make it first scale, right? The total cash needed to make the business first scale, to start the process. So number two, an actual budget should be prepared that lists all the anticipated capital purchases and operating expenses needed to generate the first one CDs, $1 in revenue. You need to be able to do that. So come out with a budget, and the budget should be prepared to list all the anticipated capital purchases, okay? All the anticipated, the items you'll be buying, all the items, all the things you will have to buy, whether you are going to hire, you are going to rent, or you are going to buy. You have to list all of that in your budget. Then you also have to look at your operating expenses. All the operating expenses. So we come to how you operate manufacturing or production. We are talking about electricity, you are talking about whatever you need, okay? The operating expenses, even salary for employees, if that will be called for. So depending on what kind of business or firm or what kind of business or firm you wish to undertake or venture you wish to launch, right? You have to come out with all of that. So all of these are needed. Then you know that my first one Ghana cedis, my first 100 Ghana cedis I want to generate, this is how much it will take me to get there. The first $1 in revenue will take me so amount to get there. You need to be able to do that. Three, the point of this exercise is to determine if the proposed venture is realistic, given the total startup cash needed. Okay, so if it is realistic, then you can go ahead. The realistic nature of the business depends on the money, the startup cash. That is what you are going through by testing this to find out, is my business viable financially? And if it is not, you begin to rethink. Okay, now let's look at similar businesses or financial performance of similar businesses within maybe the industry, maybe similar business. Talk about a business that has kind of relationship with you, not a relationship in terms of you having a rapport with them, relationship in terms of what you do, they do similar things. It may not be the same thing, but similar within the same industry, right? So what is their financial performance? So we want to find out about some of these things. One, estimate the proposed startup's financial performance by comparing it to similar already established businesses. Okay, so estimate your proposed startup's financial performance by comparing it to a similar business that is already established. So if you know a similar business that was established maybe a year ago or 2 years ago, and probably they spend such amount, you need to compare that with yours. Is yours less than? So if they started maybe probably with 10 Ghana cedis or $10, and then you are proposing in current terms that your overall startup funding will be about 6 cedis, it is not realistic. It means you don't really understand your market. So compare that. If you compare that, probably yours may even have to go a little higher. If probably they started maybe a year or two earlier, then you have to look at the inflation cost also added to the budget. So by all means, the money may go up. Two, there are several ways to doing this, all of which involve a little ethical detective work, right? Ethics is very important. Ethics is very important. You need to be moral about everything, not because you want it, so you get it at all means, from all ways, using always the means to acquire it. It is not a prudent way of doing business. You need to be honest with yourself and with others that you are engaging with. So the first thing you have to do is, you will first of all have to depend on report, right? So there are many reports available. So if you want to compare your business with similar businesses, that's why I said earlier, it is not necessarily important that you have to know them or be in relationship with them. No. You can read reports, financial reports of companies. They are all available. You go to libraries, some of these things are there, especially business libraries. So let's say, for instance, you are a PharmD student or you are an architecture student and you want to know about trying to quantify your business financially, and you are comparing it, you want to compare it with another, the best place to go is not an architectural library. You go to the business library, economics library, where such reports are often placed, and you read them. And then you know the way forward. So you have PharmD. You don't go to a pharmacy lab to look for such information. You don't go to the pharmacy library to look for such information. Go to the business library, the economics library, the law library. You'll find some of these reports. And then you'll read on them to aid you in whatever assessment you want to do. So some of these are free, right? And some also require a fee, which you will pay for. And so you should be willing, if what you need, you need to pay for it, you should be willing to make an exchange, some few dollars, few Ghana cedis, and then get it, and then you are good to go. So they will offer you detailed industry trend analysis and report on thousands of individual firms. They are there. Some of them you can find online, but online one are always not complete. You have to pay something. You have to let go some money. And if you have to contact professional bodies that evaluate that and write such report, they will also sell it. Some of these reports are on sale. So you should be willing to do that. Then you can see most of these listed similar businesses or ventures within your proposed confines that are operating, their startup capital, their competitiveness, and etc. You will learn of all of those. So if you are not prepared to read, you are not good to go as an entrepreneur. You'll be shooting yourself in the leg. And you don't need to do that. You don't need to hurt yourself that much. Seek for information if you are prepared to go as an entrepreneur. If you are not prepared to go as an entrepreneur, then don't go spend money and waste your resources and time. The second thing too that you can do when it comes to estimating your financial performance by looking through the performances of similar businesses is, one, simple observational research may be needed. You would carry out an observational research, okay? And then you'll be able to do that observational research, and you'll be able to come out with some findings. Then the third element when it comes to the financial feasibility analysis is looking at the overall financial attractiveness of the proposed venture. So the venture you want to come out or you want to launch, what is the overall financial attractiveness? Is it attractive? Will it give you what you want? Will it give you what you want? It's very important to do that. So, one, A number of other financial factors are considered with promising business startups that you have to look at. Two, in the feasibility analysis stage, the extent to which a business opportunity is positive, right, relative to each factor is based on an estimate rather than actual performance. Okay, so in your feasibility analysis, which is the first thing that you have to do, and after carrying out your feasibility analysis, all the components joined together, right, you see them highly positive. That is an estimate. That is not the actual thing. You have not set up the business yet, so you haven't seen such level of money or income coming in. So you cannot be conclusive about it. It's an estimate. And the estimate can be overwhelming or the other way. Number three, the table on the next slide will also show you some factors which you have to look at. So look at some of the factors that pertain to the overall attractiveness of the financial feasibility of the business idea. So read that on the slide that I have provided you. I asked you to download it. If you have downloaded it yet, you're good to go. If you have not yet downloaded it, I'll urge you to do so. So the financial factors that you have to look at to see if your business venture is promising enough, or if it is a promising opportunity that you have to see. One of it is this: you need to find out that you enjoy steady and rapid growth in sales during the first 5 to 7 years in a clearly defined market niche. Right? That you enjoy that. That there will be a steady and rapid growth in sales during the first 5 to 7 years in a clearly defined market niche. What is the emphasis here? In a clearly defined market niche, you have to make sure you have clearly defined your market niche, where you operate successfully, and for 5 to 7 years, you'll be enjoying steady and rapid growth, and it will be sustained all throughout, not pushing ups and down. Number two, high percentage of recurring revenue, meaning that once a firm wins a client, the client will provide recurring sources of revenue. High percentage of recurring revenue. So if you should gain a customer today, would the customer continue to buy from you? That means a recurring revenue is coming to you. But if somebody will buy from you today and move to a competitor, and it's not one, it's not two, then there is something to look at. Three, ability to forecast income and expenses with a reasonable degree of certainty. You should be able to do that. That is why it's ability. So it's something, it's a skill you learn. You learn the skill to predict or to forecast your income and expenses. You should be able to forecast. All right, if I look into the next 5 years, my income, my expenditure, should be able to forecast, and you see profits. If you are seeing profit going higher, then you know that you are in for business, right? But it should be at a reasonable degree of certainty. You should not be so sure. No, be reasonable. Can work. All things being equal, the certainty is higher, right? Okay. Number five, four, internally generated funds to finance and sustain growth. You'll be able to generate funds, right, from the business itself to sustain your growth. If you start a business, or you're going to start a business which would depend on resources from outside for the next 1 year, don't go into it. It's not feasible. Number five, availability of an exit opportunity for investors to convert equity to cash. Right? So investors will be willing to come or invest in your business for an equity. Maybe for 5%, 20%, 15%, 25%, 30%, 40%, 50%, 60%, or 75%, whatever percentage it is. There should be an opportunity for them to be able to convert it into cash if they want to exit. So I've invested into your business for about 3 years, and now I think it is time to exit. There should be an opportunity for me to gain, to convert my equity into cash, collect my money, and go away. So these are the things that we need to look at. These are the things that we need to look at if we want to be cut for the business and make business work. Then let's be prepared to face every situation at its core and be honest with ourselves that we will not be carried away just by mere exuberance and passion, but we'll be willing to use the knowledge we have acquired to apply to what we actually want, to create the future we expect. Thank you very much. On this note, I will end with you. I will continue the next section in the coming week. Thank you. Bye for now.